Another very important concept in soils is the concept of cation exchange. Now, cation exchange happens when a positively charged ion takes the place of another positively charged ion on a colloid. Okay, so a positively charged ion is essentially an atom that doesn't have enough electrons in its electron shells. A colloid is just a very, very small solid substance. In soils, there's two kinds of colloids. We have organic colloids and we have mineral colloids. Mostly in Ontario, we have mineral colloids because most of our soils are mineral soils. However, the 5% organic matter that makes up a mineral soil is extremely important for cation exchange and for creating those colloids. So how do you illustrate cation exchange? Because we're talking about things at an atomic scale. The charges involved are electrostatic charges. And so how are we going to get electrostatic charges and how are we going to see what's going on? Happen to have a really neat way to do that, and that's by using balloons. So I'm going to take a couple balloons and I'm going to blow them up. This might take a while. Once they're blown up, we have to tie them off, and I need about 4 balloons for this particular experiment. Okay, so that's one. I guess when my students say I'm full of hot air, they're not necessarily completely wrong. 2. Now, if you want to try this at home, water balloons will work really well because they're small and very thin and very light. Or smaller party balloons work as well. So next time you're at a children's party, steal some balloons and you can do some cation exchange experiments yourself. Okay, I think I'm gonna blow up one more balloon after this, and that will be enough for our little experiment. So now that the balloons are blown up, I've got to do a couple things, and I'll come back to you in just a minute, and we'll look at cation exchange and how cation exchange works in a soil. Okay, I'm back. As you can see, we still have balloons. Now, what we have to do to these balloons is we have to give them a charge. How do we give a balloon a charge? Well, the easiest way to give a balloon a charge is to rub it against something. So if you rub it against a wool top, or cotton, polyester works really well, or you can always use hair. So I've just given this balloon a charge. And let's see if the blackboard has a charge. Blackboard has an opposite charge than the balloon, and that's why the balloon sticks. So I'm gonna stick a couple more up there. You can see my hair has a pretty good charge on it now as well. Okay, there's 2. Let's throw the orange one up, a larger one. Okay, so now we have 3 balloons representing representing cations on a colloid. The blackboard is the colloid, the balloons are the cations. They have a charge that's opposite to the blackboard, that's why they stick. And let's see if we can stick a balloon on top of the balloons. I know they stick to the board, but let's see if it sticks to the balloon. And it won't. Okay? So the balloons do not stick to the balloons. As a matter of fact, they're repelled. Okay? As I get it closer, they get pushed away from the balloons. That's because the balloons all have the same charge. Like charges repel, opposite charges attract. And so if you have 2 balloons which have like charges getting close to each other, they will actually repel each other. So if I can give this one a charge and this one a charge, okay, those balloons should repel each other, and they are. Okay, I happen to have a charge opposite to the balloon. Okay. So that is how cation exchange works. Opposite charges attract, like charges repel. And so when we have a colloid of one charge and an ion of the opposite charge, they will stick together. Cation exchange is most commonly what happens. So the positively charged cations have a positive charge. They will stick to the negative spots on the colloid. Those negative spots we call cation exchange sites. But we can also have positively charged spots on the colloid, okay, called anion exchange sites. And so a negatively charged ion can stick to those positives on the colloid. Just happens that there are more negatively charged sites on colloids than positively charged sites. So colloids have a net negative charge, and so they will attract more cations than they attract anions. But a colloid will attract both. Just happens that they attract more cations. So that's how cation exchange works, by opposite charges.